Hello everyone, so today we are going to talk about a healer who used to be the queen of all supports but sadly got nerfed to the ground. Yep, it's Ying, probably the cutest champion in the whole realm. Now she's a really good healer for someone who just started playing this game and really liked playing the support role in a team. We'll talk about the buffs and the nerfs later in the video, but first let's jump into the loadout that I think is quite good for a new player or even for someone who is playing her for a while now. As you can see, the Spring Bloom is at level 4, just so if your illusion is taken out by an enemy, you can have it up as soon as possible. Then we have Carrion at level 4, just because you want your illusions to stay up as long as possible. And after that we have Mesmerism at level 2. This card is just my personal preference. All it does is increase your illusion deployment distance by 20%, which is good after the nerf to her healing range from 100 to 85 units. Next we have the most important card that you should include in every deck for her, which is Rewind. I just keep it at level 1. You can take it up to level 2 if you want. Any more than that is just a waste of points for me. What it does is when you swap to a spot of a dead illusion, it spawns an illusion with 25% HP at level 1 and 50% HP at level 2. It's just a good card to maximize your healing and it's also a key component of a resonance build. Finally, the last card is just to fill up the space. You can use anything instead of this one, but sometimes that 100 HP can save your life, you never know. Now let's discuss which one is the best legendary card for her. The default one is Focusing Lens, which is the best one in my opinion, but the other two are also usable in certain situations, I think. Now why is it the best one? Well, first of all, if you land all of your shots, the total damage output will be 800, which is a lot of damage for a healer. But for that you need a really good aim, because you have to land all those 5 shots in that burst. Only after landing all of your shots you will get that bonus 200 damage. Anyway, it's not the only reason that makes it the best card. The thing is, your illusions heal for 350 HP per second, which also got nerfed, so now it heals after every 1.2 seconds instead of 1 second. Yep, I know, that's a lot of unnecessary nerfs, which makes no sense at all, but what can we do? It's their game after all. Now, if you want to use Lifelike Legendary card, which used to be very good for healing 2 teammates at the same time, it still heals 2, but for 30% less, which means 245 HP every 1.2 seconds. Now, this is not bad, but the problem arrives when you have only one teammate in range of your illusion. Also, in higher MMR, people are smart enough to focus one player at a time, so you want to heal that one person, but you can't with this card. It really depends on your team composition. If you have 2 tanks and 2 damage carries, then Lifelike is a good choice, because you will simply stay together and healing 2 targets at the same time is somewhat better. On the other hand, if you have 2 flanks and 1 damage and 1 tank, picking Lifelike is a huge mistake. Now this card can be easily fixed by changing that 30% less healing to 20%, or if one teammate is in the range, he should get 100% of the heals. I don't think it will make her overpowered in any way. I mean, Maldumba heals for 280 HP per second with his Mending Spirit, so we can at least try it out. This game is still in beta, right? So why not? I can already see some people in the comment section be like, oh, but you need to aim with Maldumba. Oh, you need to learn how to use your gourd. Just spamming Q will make her so easy and OP. Well, Maldumba was the topmost healer even when Ying had no nerfs. And with Ceres in the meta, he is still the best healer in the game. We need more than 2 good healers in the meta right now. Now, if you want to heal one target at a time and your aim is not perfect like me, you can also try out Resonance. I personally don't like this card, but it's a very good card in smaller maps or against 2 tanks. I won't go into details. This card simply triggers a shatter automatically when your illusions expire or when you place a new one, as you can only have 2 illusions up at the same time. So if you deploy the third one, one of them will expire. Shatter is an ability where your illusions follows and explodes near enemy, dealing 500 damage. You should hardly need it if you're focusing on healing your teammates, but with resonance it's automatically triggered, as I have said before. So it's a really good card if your aim is not that good, but I would still prefer focusing lens. And if you want a loadout for resonance, please let me know in the comment section, as this one is not that good for this card. Next we should discuss about how to place your illusions in order to maximize your healing potential. So I see people place illusions on the point for tank, which is a good thing, but you don't have to place it on the point where everyone can shoot it down. Just place it behind your tank and not in the line of fire if possible. And always place one illusion in cover in the backline for your damage carries too. They need heals too. Plus it's your fallback location if things don't go according to your plan by using your dimensional link, which is F on PC. Now with this you can swap locations with your illusions for 4 seconds, and if all of your illusions are dead, it will take you to the location of last active illusion. So you need to remember where you placed your illusions if you want to make the most out of this ability. But if you don't remember, just spam F a couple of times and see where the luck takes you. Mine always takes me right in front of a salvo or a fireball. I usually place one of my illusion in cover and one near the tank. It just depends on how your team is moving. Place them according to that, and if I know that we are winning the first fight, then all my illusions will be in open, because if someone flanks me, I can simply press F and go to my team in order to keep myself safe. She's not a top tier healer after the nerfs, but after Ceres or Maldamba, she is the best one we have right now. The problem is she's a defensive healer, means you can't just run all over the map and expect her to heal you. You need to stay close to her illusions if you want her heals. This is why sometimes she does not work in a public match, as people won't pay attention to where the illusions are and just spam need healing all the time. Anyway, you cannot control that, but here are some tips which will help you improve your gameplay. Firstly, don't spam your Q blindly. Look how your team is positioned and place your illusions according to that. Like, you have to predict where your teammates are going and place it just behind them where you think they are gonna fall back to regen their health, as you can see me doing in the video. Secondly, don't forget to place your illusions in the heat of battle. I mean, you are a healer, not a damage. So always look who is low on HP and who needs your heals the most. Lastly, if you can't aim well with the focusing lens, then just go for the tanks. They are slow, they are big, which makes them an easy target to hit. If you still can't pull it off, then just pick resonance. I will try to put a loadout for that card too, but no promises. So this is it for today. I think I covered most of the things that were important. She's a really good support for someone who just started playing this game, and she's a lot of fun too. You're getting heals plus damage with her, and on top of that, look how cute she is. Anyway, if you guys have any questions, let me know and I will see you in the next one. I think I will do a healing pip. Yep, you heard it right, a healing pip. Bye. I forgot about her ultimate. So basically what her ultimate does is it heals everyone for 340 health per second for 13 seconds. No matter where you are on the map. It's not the greatest ultimate, but it's not useless too. See, I use it to heal someone who is flanking or in a bad spot where I cannot put my illusion for them. Even if it's one person, I will use it to save him. Only if we have more players alive than the other team, just to keep the man advantage on our side. That's why I go for morale boost first or cauterize. Depends on my team really. If most of them have cauterize, then I simply buy a morale boost. and Haven or Blast Shields if needed in the late games. But if you have a Sharlene or a Kanessa against you, always buy Haven, because then they would have to shoot one more bullet or arrow to kill you. Okay, so now I think I covered everything, maybe, I don't know.